Do you realize that if certain people get their way, I mean, if they get their way, 2017 is going to be a year of total confrontation, a bloody mess. What am I talking about? Can you imagine if the war fighters in Syria, who are fleeing that country right now, find their way into the United States of America and get involved in the various cells already set up in this country, and then at certain points in 2017, go kinetic. They launch their operations, whether it's in a school of elementary kids, whether it's in a busy mall on a holiday, whether it's in a movie theater, an office building, or on a university campus. Not just knives, not just automobiles, but automatic weapons. 3, 4, 5 times per day in some areas. Can you imagine an assault coming from our southern border through the cartel tunnels into Southern California? I know these things sound Hollywoodish and unimaginable, but these are the operational plans for many people involved with the Islamic State, indeed the Muslim Brotherhood, for 2017. And what we're doing today, the United West, is projecting a warning and an understanding of these problems to all good Americans everywhere. Our desire is to equip Americans to understand who the enemy is, what this confrontation is about, who the two sides are, and what can be done. When you talk about a total confrontation, it necessitates the concept of two sides. On the one side, we have this deadly coalition of the red, the communist, green, Arab or Islamic association. Indeed, in the United States, folks, the Muslim Brotherhood has joined the Black Lives Matter movement. And as Nihad Awad, the executive director of CARE, Council on American Islamic Relations, CARE is Hamas, as he recently said,
"Black Lives Matter is our matter. Black Lives Matter is our campaign."
That should be astonishing to everyone out there who understands that the Arab mind typically doesn't like black people, except as for slaves or useful idiots. Nevertheless, the Brotherhood and the Islamic State want stormtroopers on the ground to go kinetic at a given point and create social unrest. And the communists who have joined them, Tom, you're talking about communists. What are you, crazy? The Cold War is over. Oh, really? For 3 weeks right after the election, myself and other teammates infiltrated the communist movement here in South Florida.
What's the shirt you got on there, bud?
This is Vladimir Ilyich Ulyanov. You would know him better as Lenin.
We're back.
This is a Mao badge.
And so, do you support communism? Is that what you're trying to say?
Yeah, okay. I am a communist.
Okay.
We're all Marxist-Leninists.
You're Marxist-Leninist?
Yep.
But you are?
Our organization, the Fellow Travelers, we're a Marxist-Leninist organization. We're here in solidarity with all oppressed people of the world. We're here with anarchist comrades. We're here with leftist comrades.
You said you would support Marxist-Leninism.
Elaborate.
How would you like to see the country modeled? Can you give me like a country that you can see it modeled after?
The USSR, Communist
USSR?
China, for example.
Okay.
Mario 1960, not Communist China.
Think that the country would be better off being more in line with China or like Russia?
Soviet Russia, maybe, like during...
So not today's Russia, but like under Stalin?
Yeah, Stalin, Lenin even.
1, 2, 3, 4. I declare a class war. 5, 6, 7, 8. Burn the palace, Mr. Satan.
We all need to get organized, and he's right. We need to unite, and we need a common enemy. We need to get militant, and we need to be strong, and we need to stand together. Yeah. This is our revolution, and we need to remember that. What does it matter if I pick up a gun tomorrow and start shooting cops? What does it matter?
What are you trying to say here with the from Ferguson to Palestine?
We stand in solidarity with the Palestinian people.
Okay.
That have been occupied they've been occupied by Israel for decades now, but we stand in solidarity with them, and we see similarities with people in Palestine and also in Ferguson, expressing solidarity with each other because they see themselves oppressed by the same forces that we see here in the United States.
But you seem to forget that we're capable of. And we have every right to form a militia and fight back. So stand up in solidarity. Don't forget that.
We were standing in front of Donald Trump's House Mar-a-Lago, holding signs protesting Trump as members of this organization or friends of this organization. We saw what their agenda is. We saw the bizarre relationship between the Muslim world, the pro-Palestinians and communists joining together to support Gaza and Black Lives Matter movement. This is the total confrontation we're talking about. What are we going to have to do to protect ourselves? Well, understand that this didn't occur overnight, this divide. Time magazine selected Donald Trump as its man of the year and said he's the president of the divided states of America. They're 100% right. We are divided. In fact, 2.5 million more people voted for Hillary, hardcore progressive left, than for Donald Trump. That's the divide, folks. Over the past 8 years, President Obama exacerbated this divide by class warfare, race warfare, economic warfare, doubling the debt, and creating all this chaos. Thank God in heaven for November 8, 2016, where in my mind a miracle occurred and an apocalyptic cultural and national security disaster was avoided by Hillary Clinton not winning. You know, this may be a good moment to gloat, to go back. I thought for sure Trump was going to lose. But I never get tired of watching footage like this. Take a look at this.
You're awake, by the way. You're not having a terrible, terrible dream. Also, you're not dead and you haven't gone to hell. This is your life now. This is our election now. This is us. This is our country.
This is a different earth today than it was 24 hours ago. It's a different place. It just is different.
The woman who President Obama called the most qualified person ever to run for the White House couldn't break through. The question remains, who can?
Deeper concerns tonight that the world's shining light of democracy has gone dark.
Decency lost last night, and that's what's so hurtful about this.
This was a white lash. This was a white lash against a changing country. It was a white lash against a black president in part. And that's the part where the pain comes.
I kind of push back against the advancement of African Americans, of Hispanics, of women, of Muslim Americans.
It is a mourning moment for those people, and it is a moment filled with fear.
Because I'm on this network and people know my attitudes about things. They come up to me and they're scared, depressed, despair, desperate even. Almost clinging to me.
It was a rough night for everybody, I think. We're worried. The people are worried, you know? Okay, he's the president. Now what?
It feels like we're trying to avoid the apocalypse, and half of the country is voting for the asteroid.
Is there a doomsday plan?
If you have a son in the Marine Corps and that you don't trust the commander-in-chief, the people in the military defend the Constitution.
Well, America is crying tonight. I'm not sure how much of America, but a very, very significant portion, and I mean literally crying.
Everybody is crying and so upset, and it is the end of their world.
Feels like the end of the world.
We were on Lifetime last night,
right.
And I was slowly getting drunk is what happened to me.
Get your abortions now, because we're going to be and we're going to have to live with it.
How do we explain how this is possible?
How did this happen?
Because he's saying the things to people who are hurting. And it's why every beaten down, nameless, forgotten working stiff who used to be part of what was called the middle class loves Trump. He is the human Molotov cocktail that they've been waiting for. The human hand grenade that they can legally throw into the system that stole their lives from them. And on November 8th, Election Day, although they've lost their jobs, although they've been foreclosed on by the bank, next came the divorce, and now the wife and kids are gone, the car's been repoed, they haven't had a real vacation in years, they're stuck with the shitty Obamacare bronze plan, they've essentially lost everything they had, except one thing. The one thing that doesn't cost them a cent and is guaranteed to them by the American Constitution, the right to vote. Trump's election is going to be the biggest fuck you ever recorded in human history. And it will feel good.
You just gotta love that. You gotta love that. But don't enjoy that too long. As our dear friend Andy McCarthy said, Donald Trump's presidency is not the de facto solution to the problems we have home and abroad. Andy said, what we have is an opportunity. And ladies and gentlemen, we here at the United West want everybody to be prepared for that opportunity in 2017. An opportunity to avoid or deal with the total confrontation that may in fact get violent. We don't want to call people to physical confrontation. That's not our job. Our job is an ideological battle, and we operate by the rule of law. The other side doesn't. But those individuals who will be called, their phone will ring, their beepers, people have still have beepers, their beepers will ring, their cell phones will go off. Trouble over here on this avenue. They'll get up from whatever they're doing, and they'll put on their gear, strap up, and run toward the bullets and the noise and the chaos. The police men and women in the United States of America, our intelligence agencies and overseas our military. What a time to be supporting these brave individuals against the enemies of the state. Support them as we will in an organized fashion in 2017. It's a year of total confrontation. Enjoy the rest of 2016, but join with us in 2017. Here's how, two ways. One, develop a war footing mentality. You must be like the Israelis. They live in a war zone all their lives, yet they enjoy each moment of every day. Vitality, exuberance, love, joy, but they're ready to fight. That's how Americans must be, sadly. Let's stop kidding ourselves. We are at war, and we don't even know it, most of us. Work with the United West. We'll show you who the enemy is and who you are and how you can defeat the enemy. Develop a war footing. Number two, engage. We need every American engaging at some level. Whether you're confined to your home, you can engage on that keyboard. Keyboard warriors are necessary. Communicating. Maybe you want to get a little more involved and come with us to some of these events and rallies and protests. Hey, we can hook you up with people anywhere in the United States to do that, and it has to be done. I'll tell you what, as soon as Donald Trump starts pushing his policies, moving the embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem, building a wall, shutting down immigration from jihadi countries, you know the streets are going to erupt in protests and indeed riots, and the opportunity for total confrontation physically is there. We need to be out there also. If you're not the type of person that wants to go into the situation like that, that's okay. There's other ways you can support, financially or other ways. Contact the United West, we'll tell you. Bottom line, as I said, enjoy 2016, but go into 17 with your eyes wide open, knowing total confrontation in 2017, supporting law enforcement, supporting intelligence agencies, supporting our military, supporting our administration, supporting the United West, and engaging and winning because we can. And you know what? This is a good fight. This is a fight worth fighting for. This is a fight of history. And you know what? Somebody's going to fight this fight. It's either going to be us, or go look in the eyes of your children. Go look today. Grab your kid, no matter what age they are, and look in their eyes, or your grandkids, or your friends, young kids. Look at them. And tell them, you know what? I was too busy in 2017 to do what was necessary to fight the bad guys. I pushed it off to you. I hope you have a nice life. Either we're going to fight these people or our kids are going to fight these people. Hope you have a wonderful 2016. I'll see you on the other side. Let's get ready. We can win this thing.